Good afternoon to everyone. I hope the screen as well as my voice is visible and audible as well. This semester I am going to handle a subject called artificial intelligence. The subject code is CS8691. This is a sixth semester BE Computer Science and Engineering branch under Anna University Chennai Regulation 2017. Before getting into the subject, it's my usual practice to introduce the subject as well as the syllabus as well as the textbook that we are going to follow. So the artificial intelligence, students, you come across this word long back, and nowadays it is a very recent buzzword. Everyone is saying AI like that. Everywhere if you go and if you talk to someone, they talk about AI, machine learning and all. Even what are the examinations that you are taking right now, it is also an online examination, proctoring examination, that is AI enabled proctoring based, that is virtual invigilation, that you are going to take the test and you will be monitored automatically, and your facial movement and everything will be monitored, and accordingly they will be reporting to the officials who is watching your examination as well as to the higher authorities. So you cannot escape from the system, and you don't know who is watching you, but there is a system, and inside the system there is an intelligence, and that intelligence will monitor you and will report to you whatever the mistake or whatever the malpractice you have done. So that is the one best example that you can observe in your day-to-day activity as of now. So artificial intelligence being the very hot buzz topic, not only in the academic side but also in the industry, company or wherever the field you go, they are all talking about artificial intelligence. So you should know what is that. So this is the right period for you to understand the topic artificial intelligence. So the objective of this subject is to understand the various characteristics of intelligent agents. So what is mean by an agent? What is mean by an agent? Say for example, for any activity, there is a possibility for you to seek help of others and make that work done. Say for example, if I want to apply for a visa to a foreign country, I can directly go to the embassy, get an application, fill the application, submit to the embassy, and then I come back. After scrutiny of my application, they call for an interview, or they will be scrutinize my application and give me permission to visit the country what I am interested and what I have applied. But normally majority of the people won't go directly to the embassy, but what they will seek is they will seek some travel agent. So the agent also is doing the same work, but instead of you going directly, the agent will receive all your information and they will fill it on your behalf, and then they will go into the further process. Only thing, they schedule your appointment with respect to embassy for visa process, and they schedule your travel in the flight. Not only the passport, but not only the visa related activity, but also for many other things. Even for if you go to some taluk office or if you go to some government offices, they ask you to write some manu, some letter. So you are not in a position to fill up the manu or letter or some other thing. So you seek the help of others, those who are sitting outside. So they will call you and they ask you, so this is the way you have to write the letter, and they will write it and they get some money. What is the thing that I am missing? Even though you can do a job, you need some assistant to do the job on behalf of yourself, provided that helper is can do the job better than you. So that is called agent. That's why the agent, so you may cut about the term agents in many places, like broker. You can heard about the term in many places, and a term associated with the agent is intelligent. So the agent is not a one which is simply works like whatever you are ordering, they should do accordingly. So it's not an instruction based working entity. It has some self knowledge. So by means of some self driven knowledge, it act accordingly to the situation. So that is the intelligent agents. So how that intelligent has been incorporated into the agent? Agent is simply a one who is doing some help. But how that intelligent is brought into that agent? What are the characteristics? So those things you are going to understand through this subject. And then you are going to learn various search strategies in AI. Almost in AI, search strategy plays a vital, because when you are going to use a computer, the computer will try to process the numbers, will try to process the enormous amount of data, will try to process the enormous amount of values like that. So that's why in data structure itself, you have two major search strategies. One is linear search and binary search. Binary search is with respect to tree, as well as you have a traversal techniques, as well as you have a breadth first and depth first search with respect to a graph. So likewise, the search strategy plays a vital role. So that is, whenever a job is given to you with the enormous number of inputs, so it is the duty of the machine to do it very fast by applying some intelligence. So likewise, for that, there are various search strategies that are available, and through this subject, you are going to learn all these search strategies. That's the one thing. And the third point is to learn to represent knowledge in solving AI problems. Yes. So there are, you see, a human can solve any problems, but what is the problem with the human is he will take enormous amount of time for solving a certain problem. So why, say, for example, for adding two numbers, he can add with the help of paper and pencil, but he can rely on calculator. So why he is relying on calculator? Because calculator can do the calculation very faster than human beings. So that is the main intention to go to some additional assistant that work as a that work as something under the control of a human being. So in that situation, if that machine is working only on the instruction, not on their self, so that is no meaning of the word self for a machine, but instead we can make a machine to self thinking about some situations and act accordingly. So how to do that? So how you are reacting to a certain situation, you have an inbuilt knowledge, or your knowledge has been grown up over the period. So likewise, whenever you create whenever you want to solve a problems using AI, the knowledge about the problems as well as the solution strategy about the problems, or how to approach the problem, or how to deduce the various steps leading to solution to the problem, can be should be represented and should be presented to the machine in order to solve the problems. So that's the third point you wanted. So how to represent the knowledge. The fourth one, to understand the different ways. So what are the various ways? So now when you are going to design an agent with respect to a software, so there are many ways of designing that agent. So you are going to learn about what are the various ways of designing the line. And finally, in the fifth unit, you are going to learn about some applications of what are the various applications of AI. So these are the objectives of the subject. And coming to the outcomes. Outcome means after successful completion of the subject. After successful completion of the subject, what you will do is, you can choose, say, I already told in the objective, there are many kind of search algorithms are there. Of course, the duty of the artificial intelligence algorithm is make you the search process very effective and very meaningful and very faster. So after having thorough with the various search algorithms under the artificial intelligence topic, so now you are in a position, whenever you go out of the player situation or particular place, and if you face any problem, if you want to apply AI to the problem, immediately you think about the knowledge gained through this subject. Okay, for this problem, I have to apply this search strategy. This search strategy will be the one which is more helpful for understanding the problem like that. And then there are some logics available. You may heard about the term logical gates. When you are studying the digital principal system design or computer architecture. So likewise, there are software logic. So that is first order logic and predicate logic with respect to solving the problems. So in order to solve the problem, first of all, you should represent the problem. So now after thorough with the subject, after you have completed the subject with a very good marks or with a very good pass in the subject, then if any problem related to the problem that you have studied in the subject can be easily represented using the first order. So we by simply analogical thinking, okay, this is what the problem you have studied in the textbook, and that problem is represented using software, using predicate logic and first order like this. Now I have provided with a new problem, so I have to correlate how that new problem is similar to the problem that is existing and how that problem can be represented in a different way. So according to that, you have to represent the problem and you have to solve the problem using the logic. And then the third point is you will be able to provide. You will be able to, someone is asking you a help or someone seeking you a suggestion or an advice. So I have this problem and I want to solve this problem. Please tell me a suitable idea, or please suggest me a suitable or apt agent strategy. So now, if you are very thorough with the subject, then you are very familiar with the subject, you can give without referring to any book or without referring to any URLs or web resources. Definitely, we will give you a suitable agent for solving a problem. That much proficiency you will get after thorough with the subject. And the fourth one, you can be able to design your own software agent for a solving a problem. And fifth one, outcome is you can understand the NLP. What is NLP? Is natural language processing. So that is the major idea. So the major focus nowadays, you know what about Alexa, right? So they are understanding your language and they are replying to your language. That is, you are speaking to the machine. So whatever the thing you are telling, they understand the thing. And then so now, and you can find that in Google Translate or Google or even in Gmail, if you type something, say for example, so that is, this is my usual style when I am closing my email to any for official purpose or any for looking forward to hear from you like that. So before concluding, before saying thank you in email, I will use this frame. So if I type looking, so definitely the other text I need not type, everything will become as an autofill. So just I have to select and then I go. So this is the one best application where AI can be integrated with the natural language processing. So those kind of steps you will be learning, as you will be able to understand after successful completion of the subject. And regarding the textbook, they have given two textbook. One is Ruzel, and the second one is Bradco. So I suggest Ruzel book. The Ruzel book was the one which covers all the content of the syllabus. And there are some other references book. Interested students can refer the book. And one more thing regarding the study material, you can also refer web resources like YouTube channels or any other websites. You can also refer those kind of stuff, because even the your curriculum is also expecting the same, not only from teachers but also from the students. So you need not cover all the portions, you just cover 75% portion for every unit. 25% or 30% you left to the students, so that they can also use the online platform in order to understand the subject by themselves. So in that idea, also I expect you to know some URLs or some web resources during the class hours or during when the subject is going on. I will give wherever the material I referred, I will give that material to you so that you can understand, you can study well. Because they will clearly discuss you the latest trend and other things, right? So with this syllabus introduction, let me go into a PowerPoint slide presentation that introduces you about the subject. What is artificial intelligence? So this is not at all a part of your topic, part of your syllabus, but anyhow, it needs some strong basic understanding so that you can develop some creative thinking, and you can think about the idea what you are going to do after successful completion of the subject. So understanding artificial intelligence. So in that word itself, artificial intelligence, in that word itself, you know the meaning of the word intelligence separately and artificial separately. So what is intelligence? Is my screen visible? Someone is chatting with me, I guess. Let me check. Oh, sorry. Still the students are coming in. Sarun is trying to join the meeting. Yes, I think he has joined. So by the name itself, we could see that artificial intelligence, what is that? You know the meaning of intelligence and you know the meaning of the word artificial. So if you come across the word artificial, I think that and I expect that, I expect you that there is a word called natural that is just opposite that, right? So there are, so if you say artificial intelligence, then immediately you think that there might be some natural intelligence also. So that's what I'm going to discuss about. So first you should know what is natural intelligence, and then you should know how the natural intelligence is created or built. So accordingly, you have to know or you have to study about, if natural intelligence is like that and it is created like this and it is working like that, why can't be created as an artificial one? So nowadays, with respect to many biotechnological techniques or nanotechnological techniques and many science techniques, they are doing it against nature. So even they make artificial rain against the natural rain. Even they make some artificial artificial kind of many ideas. So that's the thing. So that is the word under artificial intelligence. Let me go into the topic. So with respect to natural versus artificial. So look at the picture. There is a baby and there is a computer. And there is a trainer or there is a teacher, whoever it may be. And he is asking the same question, who is your father? Both to the baby as well as to the machine. Right? So what is the scenario and how? Well, who is treated as a natural intelligence and who is treated as artificial intelligence? Anyone? Who is treated as a natural intelligence and who is treated as artificial intelligence? You can chat. Can you understand the question, what I'm telling? So here I have introduced a slide which is going to differentiate the thing between natural as well as artificial. I'm just asking your question. The question is asked to a machine as well as the question is asked to a human who is in the bum of a baby. Right. So what is the question? Who is your father is the question. Now, both think that both the man as well as the machine is having intelligence. And who is having natural intelligence? Of course, it is a human who is having the natural intelligence. And it is the machine which is created using, which is created, which has developed artificial intelligence by the people who is using the machine. So if you ask this question, since the human is in the baby form, a baby can recognize his parents, but he can't say the answer. Who is your father means he can't say the answer. My father is so-and-so or my father's name is so-and-so. Like that, he can't say the answer because he is the baby form. Likewise, when you give the say, ask the question to the machine, unless otherwise the machine is embedded with the intelligence in an artificial way, the machine can't say answer for both of the question. So both of the question means, who is your father and what he is doing like that. Any other question if you pose, ask continuously, he won't give answer. Right, so that is the difference. So a human can recognize, he can. So among the set of people, the maybe 10 to 15 people is available, a kid crawl on his own and directly go to his mother or father even in the crowd. So he can recognize, that is, he can identify, but he can't be able to speak because he is in the very baby form. He can't be able to give an answer. Likewise, when you take the computer can't recognize who is what is this image. This image is a Charles Babbage image. So he is treated as just for fun. I have included that image. He is one which is responsible for the invention of computer. So if you ask computer who is your father, maybe he may be treated as a god or father to a computer because he is the creator of the machine. So who is your father? If you ask. So that machine can't recognize as well as can't answer unless otherwise if you tell something into it. So how the Alexa is working with the help of artificial intelligence, it is working. So if you ask you a question, who is your father, maybe Alexa may give an answer, even though it is a machine, that machine is embedded with the intelligence. But here the machine is doesn't embedded with intelligence. So that is, it is artificial. So for this question, the machine can't recognize as well as can't answer. So that is the two scenarios for the thing that is to be happened. So what is the thing is, whatever it may be, even if it is natural or if it is artificial, natural is with respect to human, artificial is with respect to machine. Even if it is natural or artificial or human or machine, it has to be built. It has to be built. So how the natural intelligence is built in various stages of a human's life? So some person is needed for the baby to teach. So now you are listening to this lecture. Maybe 10 years back, if I teach this kind of lecture, is it possible for you to listen? No. Why? Because this, you have to cross several stages of your life. Then only your mindset as well as your thought process, everything will synchronize to what you talk. So in the baby form, who is the teacher or who is the one who is responsible for building the intelligence in a natural way in a baby form? They parents. The parents only say that you should do this, you should not do this, you should touch that, you should not touch that. This is your father name, this is your mother name. Like that, you are keep on talking to the kid. Even through some stories also you can talk to the kid. So that means you are building the intelligence into the machine in a natural way. So when the baby grown up, so associated with the parents, teachers came into picture. So through teacher, the student is learning many things and he is gaining the intelligence. Next, he grown up to adolescent, it is the friends. So you have parents, teachers and friends. So when you go up to a level of one who is searching degree completed, who is searching a job, so you have parents, teachers, friends. So now you have friends as well as society, because now only he is going to outside the world and seek many opportunities. Entered into a company, presented wealth, if not already come down. So now what is the thing is some kind of experience is built, has been built inside the man. So now when he is still grown up, so what is parents, now wife came into picture. Wife is also one who is more responsible for shaping the man. So wife, friends, colleagues, society. And then we still grown up, then children came into picture. So from children also we can learn, if you do any action, what is the response of the children, based on the response he can understand. So this period children are like that only, we have to go do like that. And finally, the only old man is the one who is experienced. How he got experience? So this experience is nothing but intelligence, and that intelligence is built in a natural way. How? In various stages of life. In various stages of life. But the natural is built. So above all, one thing you require is you have a books, through books. So it is a best and wonderful habit to read books, because books can talk to you. Even a person can talk to you. Right, so through books also you can understand certain things, and your knowledge can be improved. So this is the way of building natural intelligence. So how the natural artificial intelligence has been built? So here also you have the different forms of machine, from primitive form machine to the smart form. This is the primitive form machine to a smart form. You have different varieties of machines. This machine also can have some kind of intelligence. And the common people may ask, why not? Why not the intelligence can also be incorporated into the machine? Unnecessarily, that intelligence will be discussed only with the higher level people. So why not the intelligence cannot be built using the something like that is helpful for building the intelligence in the machine? Why not? Like that question, sir. So if you want to make that intelligence to be built in an artificial way, so what the thing is, you need an algorithm, because these are all the machines that works by the instruction developed. So whenever you have to expect a machine to do a process, for example, you are writing a sorting program, and you are expecting a machine to give some solution or some answer to the sorting problem. So what you can do is you can do some algorithms or instruction, or based on the algorithm instruction, you can either, if you are using computer means you will be provided with the code, or if you are not with computer, you can manage with the help of your speech, then you have to make yourself to be ready. So that the intelligence can be built accordingly, and then you can give answer. So on the whole, what is required is, if your machine has to do intelligence in an artificial way, first of all, you should know thorough the machine architecture and its culture, sorry, and its connections and everything. You should know it clearly. Then only you can give. Then only you can build intelligence in an artificial way. So first thing, what is required is algorithm, which means set of instructions. Where that algorithm comes? That algorithm comes from data. So this is the main thing, that is data. See, in the previous case itself, I already told you, searching. So when the data gets accumulated and it is going more and more, so what you have to do is data will get more thing, and you are able to remember all the thing that is happened the day before yesterday or tomorrow. Like that, you need a data. So that data will be from the data, by understanding the nature of the data, by understanding how the data is there. So where the data comes from? The data comes from problem. So you have a problem context. From the problem context, you have to choose a data, and that data will be divided into thing that is meant for building, that is meant for creation, like that. So anything that can be worked out can be utilized from the problem context. So this is what the building. So what? How the natural business is built? Actually, it is built with the various processes involving in the in his life, throughout the life. And what is how the artificial intelligence is built? It is built based on, by developing an algorithm with the help of the data. That data comes from the problem context. So this is the scenario. So there are thing which is required to understand between traditional computer programming and programming to create students, programming to create artificial intelligence. So what is that idea is, let me take one example for that. What is that
thing here you need to do is you can maybe I will
In traditional computer programming, you have a data, and that data will be utilized with respect to input, and this input will be somehow associated with the program, and it is the duty of the computer to take the input as well as based on the instruction in the program, it analyzes the data and proceeds with the data, and it will produce the output. Say for example, the programming is meant for a sorting or searching, so whatever it may be. So what the thing you will give, you will give some data. So data in the form 5, 10, 2, 3, like that, some data will be given, and accuracy you will give is what kind of sorting. Say for example, it is a quick sort, means you will be giving the quick sort. So based on the instruction in the quick sort, then it will accept the input, and that is processed inside the computer, and you will get the output. What is the output? The number in the ascending order. So how to create artificial intelligence through programming? So what you need is the data here is input. So whenever you go for a data, you have two things, input and a set of output. So you have to give both the input and output. And there are certain strategies that you need to do. There are certain strategies. See, keep remember, strategies or some techniques or some methods. So what is the strategies or methods is going to do is it will accept the input and accept the output, and it will try to correlate between the input and output. You try to correlate the fact between the input and output, and according to the correlation that is between input and output, it will generate some algorithm, some program. It will create program, and this program is now embedded into a chip. And that chip is embedded into the hardware of the machine. Now the machine is building the artificial intelligence. So that is the thing. So you need to give the input and output. So this point is more important, that is the strategies. So this is what we are going to see in this subject. There are many strategies or many methodologies available for creating artificial intelligence. That is objective is to accept the input data and accept its corresponding output, process the input and output, and then it produces a program. So that is the strategy. So that's what we are going to see in this subject. So this strategy will differ according to the version. So sometimes you may treat this strategy as an artificial intelligence strategy. Sometimes you may treat this strategy as a machine learning strategy. Sometimes you may treat that strategy as a data mining strategy. Sometimes you say that as a neural network. Sometimes you say that fuzzy logic, evolutionary computation. Sometimes you take that the deep learning strategy. So that's the idea. So here it is not a program. Here it is not a program like this that is intended to produce output. But here this is treated as some kind of strategies. This idea is to study the relationship between input and output. If this is the set of input, and how much the output will be, and how the output will be. So those kind of strategies are produced, and the program is coming out. This program is nothing but the one which is helpful for create artificial intelligence. It has to be embedded into the chip, and that chip has been taken back to the process. So that is the difference between traditional computer programming with respect to artificial intelligence. How to build that intelligent artificial? How to build? So in general, I told that when you want to create an intelligence, you need a data. So that is to be entered into two stages. One is a training stage, another one is a testing stage. So it needs a lot of explanation for you to understand the strategies or training strategy as well as testing. Just you now keep remember that the data should be divided into two. Say for example, if you are submitting 100 data here, in general, some more number of data will be submitted to training, and some proportion less or lesser number of data will be submitted to testing. So that training data will, what it will do is it will study the data, and it tries to adjust the parameters as well as structures. So what parameter structures has been I told that the strategies will try to build a program. So that program will contain some parameters, right? Variables, and the program can contain some structures, right? So you try to adjust the parameters and the structures. So once that program is ready, now before embedding into the chip, now you have to check whether the program is working good or not for certain unknown inputs. So those in unknown outputs that is not submitted to training will be taken separately as a testing, and this data will be submitted to that box. That box will, what it will do is it will understand that it is a trained model, because the trained model will only coming here. And this train model can be accepting the test data, and it will try to do the thing, whatever the thing that is done during the training stage. And it will try to give the output, and from the output we can come to understand that. So this is the accurate level of the testing strategy for a particular set of input that is unknown during the training process. So this is the way. So now what is that? During training, we are teaching something. And during testing, we are accessing something. Seriously, here we are giving training, and here we are giving assessing. The same thing will be treated as, say for example, now I may treat this title as development of intelligence in a natural way. Development of intelligence. So in natural way means your brain. So intelligence, where intelligence is referred with respect to human organ, it is brain. So how to develop intelligence for a human brain? That is how to develop intelligence in a natural way. So assume a classroom model. You are coming to a sixth semester BCSE, and you are asked to learn certain subjects so that if you score good marks, then you may be treated as you have crossed the sixth semester successfully by holding all the good marks. So what you are, how you are getting that stuff? So it may be a 3 months period of semester. During the 3 months period of semester, a teacher will come to you, and the teacher will teach you the subject. So the teacher will not teach all the content. The teacher will cover major content without omitting any topic. But whatever the teaching given by the teacher will be in a direct way, and this is called teaching period. The training period in terms of artificial intelligence is a teaching period. So the teaching period, what the students will start understanding the subject, adjusting their parameters here refers to adjusting to the new terminologies of the subject. Some may feel that, oh, we come to sixth semester, these are the subject given, we should study. Either with some kind of lethargic mind also, they can enter into the subject, at least to get the results. So likewise, so during the teaching period. So teaching period, whatever the things that are done, we have given an assignment, we are provided with some tutorials, we are provided with the classroom tests, we are provided with some internal assessment tests, everything has been done. So each time, say for example, in the first assessment test, we score low mark, means then I will tell you some tips, or you will, if you feel, realize yourself, so our mark has been come, so you will adjust yourself. So this time, these three times we have gone for ground and played, we have used it, internet, and we have watched the TV, we are not committed time to study, hence we have scored lesser marks. So what you will do is, you will adjust your timings, and you will adjust your habits, and you will try to focus yourself on the subject. So that is for the testing period, teaching period with respect to development of intelligence in a natural way. And what is this, the test stage with respect to artificial, with respect to, here is examination. So once you have completed the 3 months period of semester duration by adjusting your parameters, by understanding the subject, now now the university authorities will check whether you have successfully understood the subject or not. So for which they will be conducting some examination, that is, use the trained model. So use the taught student to verify how much knowledge the student has got. To verify its correctness means how much knowledge the student has got in that subject. Accordingly, he may be in a position to give the mark. So you will be writing the test, and based on the test written by you, you will get some marks, and that marks will decide you whether you have secured pass in that subject or not. So if you have successfully passed the subject, you are allowed to go for higher semester. If you are not, you have to repeat the subject. So it means if you have successfully passed the subject, it means you have enough knowledge about the subject. So that means your intelligence about the subject has been built. So that is the development of intelligence in a natural way. So if you have failed in the subject, means that the knowledge that you have gained through the teaching of this subject is not enough. So you have to, one more time, you have to go for studying the subject, and then you come with a good mark, so that your intelligence about the subject has been clear. So your mark sheets proves that one. So based on the grade that you have scored for the subject, it will be treated as, okay, you have certain intelligence in the subject. Apart from the intelligence, they will be asking you a question, what is your subject of interest. So that means you have more intelligence in that subject than the other subjects. So that is the way. So you have to correlate this thing with respect to the idea of intelligence. So this is not required here, learning to create intelligence artificially, because it is a very tougher topic. It may come under machine learning. What are the tasks of artificial intelligence? How, what are the things that you are going to make? Why you need to make intelligent artificially? You have to do pattern recognition, that is automatic finger recognition, facial recognition, iris recognition. You need to do it automatically by machine without a human being. And you need to make certain decisions, not only this kind of decision like eating food, but for major things, maybe you want to automate the military tank, you want to automate the boiler, you want to automate any machines for which you need to take a decision making. So likewise, optimization. So if you are provided with the n number of alternatives, say for example, last time you have heard about this term very well in the subject decision analysis of algorithms with respect to optimization, how to prepare optimal schedule, dynamic programming and all. So these are the tasks that can be executed by artificial intelligence. So if you could see the technology hierarchy, you have heard about many terms. So artificial intelligence is the term that is treated as a superior term. Under artificial intelligence, you have machine learning. Under machine learning, you have soft computing, computational intelligence techniques, or artificial neural network. Under artificial neural network, you have shallow neural network and deep neural network. That is a deep learning. So these are the technology. So everything is tightly packed together with one another. So you cannot separate. This is separate, and this is a new one, and this is totally different one, like that. And what is the kind of artificial intelligence that we are going to see today is that we are going to see this syllabus is. So in this syllabus, the artificial intelligence techniques that you are going to see is with respect to agents. So this is a very primitive artificial intelligence methods, because human's brain will start understanding the pictures rather than the letters or numbers, whatever it may be. So that is what the knowledge represents. So that's why your ancient letters are something like Chinese or Japanese letters are something like pictures. So even man talk to the other person with the pictures only. Say for example, if you go to any periodic cultures, Karappa, Mohenjo cultures inside the caves, you can see a lot of paintings. Through paintings only they try to convey something. So likewise, that is called symbolic symbols, through symbols. So that's the idea here. So symbolic reasoning is the one that we are going to see in this artificial intelligence subject. So we are not going to touch machine learning. We are not going to touch artificial neural network, and we are not going to touch deep learning. So you don't think about that. Artificial intelligence means, okay, we are going to touch all this stuff. That is not the idea here. But the current and the industry, what is the current industry is expecting in the name of artificial intelligence is these things. So if you say that I have studied artificial intelligence, start for the current scenario, what is expected from you is, you know, artificial neural network, you know, machine learning, you know, deep learning. But the artificial intelligence that is discussed in this textbook is not that much expected, but this is the fundamental. This is the fundamental, because that fundamental will give you a lot of problems, and that problems will take you to the next level understanding of the higher level artificial intelligence ideas. So that's what we are going to study in this subject. And what is the textbook that is to be followed? This is the textbook, Artificial Intelligence, a Modern Approach, third edition. So please, student, remember that the artificial intelligence here that we are going to discuss in this subject is a kind of artificial intelligence that deals with agents, agent-based intelligent techniques, and as well as it is called symbolic reasoning. So you have many topics here based on that syllabus, all the things that we covered in the single book. So I will create a Google Classroom and I will upload all the material. For students, first you create a WhatsApp group, and I will share the Google Classroom code. You can join the Google Classroom, and whatever the material that you have prepared for the subject, I will upload it in the Google Classroom, as well as whatever the content that I have delivered through online. So it has been recorded and it will also be uploaded in the YouTube, as well as it will be referred in the Google Classroom. So with this, with this few introduction about the subject, I close the today's session. Maybe in the coming days, I will teach the subject unit-wise, one by one. Okay, let me stop the recording first.